Hello everyone, welcome to BizOrTech. In our last video, we solved problems based on calendars, and now we are heading on to the last segment of problems. So now let's begin with the 11th problem. How many odd days are there from 13th May 2005 to 19th August 2005? Both the days inclusive. And here you can see that it's of the same year. So you have different options to find out the odd days, and you know, to get this you have to go through manual method itself. So let's begin with the solution. Here we have to count the number of days from 13th May 2005 to 18th August 2005, both the days inclusive. So if you take May 13th to 31st May will have 31 days, so 19 days, and then after May, June 30 days, July 31 days, and April 1st to 19 days. And now add all these days, you will get 99 days. And after getting this, very easy to find out the odd days, divide 99 by 7. And you will have only one odd days. 99 will go by 7 in 14 times. So 1 will be the odd day. So in there is only one odd day in the given period. And that will give you the right answer option, option A, 1. I hope this is clear, and let's move on to the next problem. If today is Monday, what will be the day 350 days from now? So these kind of problems are like a piece of cake, so you just have to grab it because they appear very rarely. So when it's 350, you know how to calculate days or the corresponding number or whichever, whatever it is, it's through odd days method. So you have different days. So simple, the solution is as simple as it is. Take 350 days, divide by 7, and it will exactly go in 50 weeks. So no odd days means there is no change in the day. So it will be a Monday again. So your answer option is option A, Monday. So that was pretty easy. And now let's move on to the next one. Arun went for a movie 9 days ago. He goes to watch movies only on Thursdays. What day of the week is today? So now we have to calculate which day it is. So let's begin with the solution. Clearly it can be understood from the question that 9 days ago was a Thursday. Why? Because he goes to watch movie only on Thursday. So now if you rule out 9 days, from 9 days, if you rule out a week, it will give you 2 odd days. And if it's a Thursday, and then what day it will be? Extra plus 2, which will give you Saturday. So it was 9 days before, it was Thursday when he went for movie. So 2 odd days is there. So add 2 odd days for the Thursday. So it will give today. And today will be Saturday in his case. So your answer option will be option D, Saturday. Now let's move on to the next question. Second Saturday and every Sunday is a holiday. How many working days will be there in a month of 30 days beginning on a Saturday? And you have different working days. Here, this is the end. Saturday, if the month is beginning on Saturday, means the first day of the day will be Saturday. So that will take us to solution. If the day is Saturday, the corresponding, the next consecutive day will be a Sunday. So if 2nd is a Sunday, now add 7 to it. 9th will be a Sunday, 7, then 16th, then plus 7, 23, plus 7, 30. You can't exceed 30 because that's where the month ends. So 5 Sundays is there, and along with that, these total 5 Sundays are holiday now. 2nd Saturday is also holiday. If you need the date of 2nd Saturday, 1st is a Saturday, plus 7, 8 is a 2nd Saturday. So 5 plus 1 will give you 6 days total, and if you subtract 6 days from a month of 30 days, you will have the answer, which is 24 days. So the month will have 24 days in this scenario, and the right answer option will be option B, 24. I hope this is clear. Now we will see the last problem in calendars. How many times does the 29th of the month occur in 400 consecutive years. So there is a lot to think about this. So there might be any number of times, because every month will have 29 as a day, and also in leap years, February will also get such day. So here there is something that you need to carry forward and save it. So that is, in every 400 consecutive years, there are 97 leap years, and this calculation is huge. So it's better that you take this and carry forward. So 97 leap years will be there. So let's keep that aside now. So if you leave that, those leap years, then there will be the remaining years, which will be like 11 months. If you, all these leap years means those day, those years in which the February is having 29th as a day. So that will keep, that will be 97 itself. So in the rest case, 400 consecutive years, 11 months are there. So 400 into 11, 4400 times 29 will come. And in that case, February has not been added because we have considered only 11 months. No. Now what you need to do is 4400 plus 97, which is the February 29th, the leap year days, it will give you 4497. So giving you the required answer option 4497, option C. So these can be a kind of hypothetical questions which might occur. So you can anticipate these questions as well, and it's better that you save a special things like this. So this one and every 400 century, so which day cannot be ending, so that could be Tuesday, Thursday and Saturday. So if you save all those things, it will help you a lot in problem solving. So with this, we'll be winding up the problems based on calendars, and in the next videos we'll come with even more interesting topics in problem solving. Thank you so much for watching.